So I've made a lot of videos about tiling window managers, and one of the things that's always bothered me is that when I make those videos, I get a lot of negative comments saying things like, hey, tiling window managers suck, or they're not useful, or they're not worth your time. And these kinds of comments, they bother me because the arguments against tiling window managers a lot of times are rather dishonest and disingenuous. Now, I don't want to suggest that everyone should be using a tiling window manager and that's the only right way to use a computer. That's nonsense too. I understand that opinions vary. I love tiling window managers. You may have tried them and don't like them, and that's a valid opinion too. I'm not talking about just people stating an opinion. You should use what you like. You should use what works for you. But the kinds of comments I'm responding to are not the, hey, I don't like using tiling window managers, or I'm not comfortable using tiling window managers. Those are perfectly valid opinions, and I can respect those opinions. No, the dishonest and disingenuous comments I'm talking about are the ones that say things like, tiling window managers take too much time to configure. You often hear tiling window manager critics say things like that. Tiling window managers take too much time to set up, to configure. There's too much effort involved to get started, right? And I just think that's completely false. It's like everything else you do. Yeah, there's some work involved in the beginning, but that's with everything. I mean, yes, you're going to have to spend maybe a few hours to configure your tiling window manager at the very beginning, but at the end of it, it gives you a really nice, efficient workflow because you configured it exactly the way you wanted it. And even the big traditional desktop environments on Linux, such as GNOME, KDE, XFCE, Mate, etc., or the traditional desktop environments that ship on Microsoft Windows or the Mac OS, people spend time configuring those desktop environments too. It's not like it's a window manager only thing that you have to configure and tweak the desktop. No, you do that on desktop environments too. So that argument that tiling window managers are a chore or a real hassle because you have to configure them and it takes a lot of time to configure them, well, that same argument applies to every desktop environment or window manager across the board, regardless of operating system. But the benefit with a tiling window manager is you only have to configure it the one time. Yes, you spend a few hours. There's a few hours of upfront costs that you got to spend to configure it. But once you configure it, it's that way from now till the end of time. You're not ever going to get that with a traditional desktop environment because you're limited on the customization you can do, but also these desktop environments change drastically from each major version to the next. So you're going to have to learn a new kind of workflow every time GNOME switches from GNOME 2 to GNOME 3, for example, or KDE switches from KDE 3.5 over to KDE Plasma 4. You know, there's new stuff that you have to deal with desktop environments that you never have to deal with window manager only. Because when you do window manager only, you configure it to your liking and it's always that way. It never changes unless you change it. So the argument that tiling window managers take too much time and effort to configure is actually completely false. As a matter of fact, we should turn that around. It's actually the desktop environment that people spend far too much time tweaking and configuring, right? You will spend so much less time configuring if you just switch to a window manager because, again, you just do it one time and for the most part, you're done after that. Maybe you add make some minor tweaks every now and then, but it's never going to be a complete reworking of the configuration and trying to learn a new workflow or anything like that. Those days are over once you do window manager only. One of the other dishonest arguments I often hear people say is that tiling window managers have steep learning curves that don't really amount to any gain as far as productivity or efficiency. So it's really tough to learn this stuff. And when you finally learn it, you didn't gain anything. You didn't become a more efficient or more productive computer user. Now, this one is so ridiculous. I think this is obviously nonsense. And anybody that's ever used a tiling window manager will tell you it's complete nonsense, that argument that it has this steep learning curve, but when you learn it, you don't really gain anything. That's just patently false. I think some of the people that say these kinds of things, they just like to parrot this argument just because they think it supports their argument, but it really doesn't. Yes, there's some tiling window managers out there that have very steep learning curves like DWM and Xmonad and things like that, but that steep learning curve, it allows you ultimately to configure your window manager to your exact needs. And that initial effort you have to put in ultimately allows you to make your workflow of your window manager more effective. So yes, it's absolutely worth it. Is it worth it for that steep learning curve? Yes. There are real and significant gains in productivity and efficiency once you have everything set up. And I really don't think this is even debatable. Those of you that are spouting that nonsense, please stop saying this. If you don't like tiling window managers, just say you don't like tiling window managers, but don't make up false arguments against them. Another one that sometimes people say is, I have to relearn everything about my computer to use a tiling window manager. I have to relearn how to do everything. And there is some truth to that you do have to relearn everything. Moving and resizing windows is now a hassle because now you got to remember all those key bindings, right? Maybe you miss some of the standard desktop environment key bindings that you're used to on GNOME and KDE or even Windows and Mac OS. So things like your Alt-Tab key binding doesn't do what it did, you know, on those traditional desktop environments. Control-Alt-Delete maybe or maybe not does anything for you. Things like that. But tiling window managers, also another one that you have to relearn. Tiling window managers are all about workspaces. You have all these virtual workspaces, and if you're on a multi-monitor system, you immediately discover that tiling window managers don't act anything like a traditional desktop environment, because on multi-monitors, every tiling window manager, as far as I know of, treats multi-monitors as their own separate workspace. Each monitor is its own workspace. That is not the way that most traditional desktop environments do it, and it's definitely not the way that Windows or Mac OS do it. So yes, you will have to learn how to use your computer in a completely different way, but that's not a valid critique. And why is that not a valid critique? Because everything new requires you to learn new things. So of course, you know, learning a new window manager requires you to learn new things. Learning a new anything requires you to learn new things. If you were so afraid of trying out something new and trying out something different, then why are you even running Linux? Think about that for a second. And because I'm not sure if you guys realize this, those of you that spout this nonsense about why you shouldn't use tiling window managers or learn anything about tiling window managers, all those arguments you're using, Windows and Mac users could use those exact same arguments against you as far as Linux. You know, the same reasons why I won't switch from Windows to Linux is because of things like there's too much time involved, it's too hard to configure, I have to relearn everything. And that's the Windows user telling you that same stuff about Linux. And you're a Linux user and you're telling other Linux users those same arguments about tiling window managers. So don't be that guy. In fact, to be honest, I actually respect those kinds of arguments from Windows and Mac users more than I respect those arguments from Linux users. Because after all, those Windows and Mac users, they just simply went out and bought a computer. They went to Best Buy or wherever and they bought a computer. It came with that operating system. They never touched it, did anything to make it work. They never had to install the OS or they didn't configure the desktop environment. Yeah, they literally did nothing with their computer. So when they make these kinds of arguments, I get it. I respect those people saying that. But you Linux users saying those things, you know you're being just completely dishonest when you say those things, because as a Linux user, you made this choice to explore this new realm of possibilities with your computer, right? When you chose that OS, this new OS, whatever you were using before, you went out and you looked at distrowatch.com or whatever, and you went and found the Linux distribution of your choice, and you downloaded that ISO, which is a major commitment. Burning the ISO to a disk or a thumb drive, a major commitment. Actually installing the operating system, that's a huge commitment. So you're already halfway down this road of exploring all the possibilities you can do with a computer. Don't be afraid to go the whole way. So please stop trying to scare people away from learning things like tiling window managers. If you're in the Linux community, you know, you hang out on Linux forums or Linux chat rooms, or you write Linux content for journals, or write Linux articles, news articles, or you have a Linux YouTube channel, because I've seen people in all those areas try to scare people away from tiling window managers. They actually try to block people and try to shut it down before these people ever get a chance to even learn anything about these tiling window managers. And I just think those tactics are so bad, because I don't know how you guys can even engage in that kind of activity when it's the same thing that Windows users try to do, you know, blocking people from ever exploring Linux. You know, they try to put it in their head before they ever even go out and explore Linux, how bad and how hard it is to get into Linux, and nothing's ever going to work and you're going to waste all your time. That's what you guys are doing with your tiling window manager arguments, and I just needed to call some of you guys out on that. Now, before I go, I need to thank a few special people. I need to thank the producers of the show: Michael, Gabe, Corbinian, Mitchell, Devin, Fran, Arch5530, Akami Channel, Chuck, Claudio, Donnie, Dylan, George, Kell of Devils, Lewis, Paul, Scott, and Willie. These guys, they are the producers of this episode. They are my highest-tiered patrons over on Patreon. I also want to thank each and every one of these ladies and gentlemen. These are all my supporters over on Patreon because this channel is supported by you guys, the community. If you'd like to support my work, consider doing so. You'll find DistroTube over on Patreon. All right, guys. Peace.